Welcome back to Sins Gaming Channel. My name is Michael and this is another tutorial for Railway Empire 2. So, to quick resume, in the last tutorial I was talking about advanced cargo distribution and warehouses, and while it does work, it is not very efficient. It does what it wants to do, but it does it weirdly, let's put it like this, because everything was set to automatic and that somehow the game logic has problems with that. As soon as you have more than one good over more than two stations, it gets really weird sometimes. It will skip three stations to pick something up and then to pick up one good to then deliver five stations later and nothing in between. So to avoid that, you will want to manually set your cargo trains. Passenger trains, you really don't have to care. You can, if you want, you can split. Then, no, doesn't matter. Doesn't matter. You know that? This one is just about cargo and warehouse distribution. So we have this little cluster here with the cities of Albany, New York, then everything else down there, with Coal Terminal being the warehouse station. And then we have Hilton, Williams, Thomas Rest. Here, there's three stations. Rural stations which bring goods, plus these two goods that are already here. They are already on the station anyway. So we're going to make a distribution just with these two cities plus the warehouse. Just to proof of concept, I guess. So what we need is, we need trains to deliver the goods from these three stations into Coal Terminal. Now, in the last episode, I made one train who would service all three stations, which works, but it's slow to start because it will not pick up most the good that it actually needs in the order you actually want. So, for example, if you set it to start here, go through here, start, go through here, through here, through here, it maybe runs empty all the way to the third station just to pick up the milk and then deliver it eventually. And yeah, it's not very efficient. It will work, it will over time work, but it's not very efficient and you will use a lot more trains than you should have to use. So we're going to use one train from each station like this, a simple go. Now this is only one good, so we don't need to specify what it has to load, because it can't only load grain and it can't load anything else because nothing is required here. So we don't have to set it manually here. Just gonna one train. What we're going to do, however, is we set the minimum wagon to one, so it will not run empty. If it's empty, if it has no demand for the good, it will stay. You can see that right here, because no train is leaving here, meaning that in theory it should not load anything. So you can see it's waiting for goods, because it will only deliver goods to the warehouse that are requested by another line. It will not deliver goods to the warehouse and stock them, unlike in Railway Empire 1. So if you don't know why it doesn't stock goods in the warehouse, that's why. The warehouse is just to transfer goods from one line to another. So there has to be a demand for a good, a specific demand. And I'm going to show you in a second. So we're going to do the same thing from William Terminal, of course, with the freight. And again, number of wagons, minimum one. Okay. And then the same from Thomas Rest with one minimum wagon. There you go. So now this three, the intake has been set. And then also I want to add something else here. You'll see why in a second. That was cloth. Yeah. You don't need to add this, the goods that are already here, because they're already here. They don't need to be transferred. So now we're going to make distribution. And I already have one of my cats attacking me. Like, hey, give me hugs. And just gonna lay down. Okay. Ah, that was my cat. Anyway, so now the first train I'm gonna make is to Albany. And I'm gonna just check in Albany what it needs, or what it doesn't need. It's easier. It doesn't need livestock, it doesn't need wool, it doesn't need coal that I don't have. It needs everything else. And it produces beer with grain. So the grain demand is a lot higher. But it needs everything else except those intermittent products, I guess. So, we make a train from coal terminal to Albany. By the way, in this example, I'm going to keep the station here at just those two tracks. But in your game, once you have more than two cities, I will only use two cities for the example, but you can deliver 5, 6, 7 cities from here. Even more, I guess. You will probably want to add tracks and make it more accessible. For example, that's not better. The more tracks, the better. Because you want to have the trains as well here set to one minimum good. So you want every train that departs have its own rail to be able to wait without blocking any other trains. But that's not necessary here, because we're only doing these two cities. But it applies after to 3, 4, 5, it's the same principle. So, we have this train from coal terminal to Albany. Now we're going to set it to manually. Manually means that you have to specify every cargo it loads and unloads at every station, which is a lot easier than it sounds. So we're going to choose the Derwent, and we're going to make it just 2 for this example. After you can check if it needs 2 or not. Does it need 2? I don't care. For now, it needs 2. Just for the example. So near this one, you can switch to the stations here. You can click the offer goods that you want it to depart with. It won't wait for all the goods to be available, but it will only take the goods that it is allowed to take. Like, for example, I wanted 1 lumber, 1 sugar, 1 cloth, 1 milk. And I don't need beer, and I don't need wool. So these are 4 basic goods that it needs. And the rest, I put it to grain. The above line here means that it will unload this in this city. Simple, this is just because it's not set to anything here. As you can see, here it's loading, unloading, because it would skip this station, because nothing has been determined. So, to unload here, we clean this out here, because we don't want it being loaded here. So now it will unload grain, all these goods in Albany, load here, unload here. But of course, we don't want it to go back empty. No. We want it to take beer. Again, it doesn't wait for 8 units of beer to take 1, 2, 3 as many as they are available and as many as they are required by the other lines to distribute. Just to make that sure. And we don't set a minimum wagon here for now, because it will just go back and forth, and with only 2 cities, that's all fine. So when I set this, and it will have wood. By the way, it will have wood right from the get-go. So we're gonna okay here, confirm, and now we'll go in and we'll take wood, because that's the only thing we can take, and it will start. And now we will see here, as you can see now, it starts to load the other trains, because now there is a line that demands, you can see it, those goods are all reserved for Albany now. Because there is a train that takes the goods to Albany, the goods are reserved the moment they are leaving the station, they are reserved for wherever city they go. If you change the line, if you change anything, the goods are lost. I don't know if they go back to the rural station or not, I have no idea, but if I change the train, and to tell it to unload somewhere else, the goods are gone. So be sure to make that clear. So, and now we have this one train here, as you can see here. It doesn't come back with beer right now, because it has no beer production, or Rider? No. It should have beer, actually. It has one in stock. The reason it doesn't bring any beer back, I think, now is because nobody's demanding beer, because I haven't sent beer to Albany. So, you will see now, if I put the station, now the next line, from coal terminal to New York City, again, we have manually. So I'm going to set it up. Again, I'm going to, now, one grain, one lumber, one beer, one sugar, one milk. And the rest, wool. Because in New York, we produce cloth with wool. And so we don't need cloth. So we're going to next to the next one here. There we go. Gonna remove all this. And now we will unload all this. And we tell it to pick up the cloth. Okay. And because New York is a big city and it's a farther away than Albany, we're going to make it two trains. There we go. Now we confirm. Again, the reason why it only picks up wood and wool is because those are two goods that are produced locally here. But it doesn't take anything else because every good that is here is already reserved. If you look here, they have grain for Albany, sugar for Albany, milk for Albany, and beer for nowhere. But now it's demand beer because we added beer for New York. So let's see. Did they actually make two trains for Albany? Oh yeah, I did. As you can see now, it brings the goods to Albany. And it brings beer back to the warehouse. Isn't this beautiful? I just figured that I didn't build supply that area. Which could probably come handy. You can see now it's in Albany, it unloads and it loads beer. Because now there is a demand on the system. But not enough. Not enough. Again, when you have more cities, then there's more demand. And again, it comes back with these goods here. And because New York hasn't transported cloth now yet, there is no cloth yet. But this will income now, as you can see. And then it will bring the cloth as well to Albany. And, well, while I am, you can simply do this for every station. Just have to check that the demand of the lines are not exceeding the offer of the stations. We have to upgrade to keep up. You always want to produce more than you need, because otherwise you get cities that are missing stuff, and yeah, that's not perfect. So as you can see now here, Philadelphia have meat. So we still have a place. We still have a spot open here in the warehouse. So we're gonna add meat. Now, you have to keep in mind, if you add something like this, of course you then have to edit your lines to accommodate for that. So for example, we're going to coal terminal, we're gonna say add meat. And here it will unload meat. You have to add the goods or it won't pick it up. Later on, if you have bigger cities who produce something, you can have a special line that just brings, for example, for Albany, instead of having like this, you can simply make a line on its own that will bring just grain and take beer. But for now, this is good enough because it will really bring beer. So anyway, I confirm this. The same with New York City here, of course. We're gonna edit it. So we take one less wool. There you go. I confirm. Okay, and then we have. So we take coal to Philadelphia. But While we set it to take Meteor, Philadelphia doesn't actually have any livestock. Well, no. Never mind, I didn't saw this. Philadelphia's the livestock coming from here. It doesn't have a train, but it will still take the livestock from here. So it will produce meat. So we make this line, this last line, before the end. So manually. Now we can have three because it's further away. And I'm gonna set the goods. One grain, one lumber, one beer, one sugar, one cloth, one milk. Hey, it's good because I don't need to deliver anything else. Yes, that's it, I think. Did I put anything? I take meat, I don't need wool. There you go. Now, if you have empty spaces, you can add all goods. Meaning that it will fill the last two with whatever goods it's needed more. You assure that every good is delivered, but if you have leftovers, just as well. This basically is a partial automatic. You could put all this, but that would be the same like automatic. So now we go here, and we're going to unload all this. As you can see, this is the example I was looking for before. Milk is not needed yet in Philadelphia, so we cannot unload it. So what we're going to do is, we're going to remove milk. We're going to add another one like this. There we go. And we're taking meat back to Philadelphia. There we go. And confirm. Now I'm going to hurry this up a little bit. And again, the first train will only take lumber because it's the only thing that's available for Philadelphia. Now let's see here at what point it will need production. That being said, you can let it like this for street delivery, I guess. But you probably want to have a train station eventually. So that's what we're going to do here. Because I don't know if it's... I have no idea if it's used or not. Yeah, actually, see, it's used. There is a spike here. So in theory, that means... I really don't know if it's producing. Actually, okay. The reason it's not taking anything is that you really don't need the train station here. I was really correct about that. If it's just one good for one city like this, that's enough. It doesn't need more. The reason it's not producing is because it has... You see here? Now it's going down and it's producing. So it's going up. It has all this ready and the train has picked up something here. There you go. You can see it takes up the meat, and the second train here is already coming with sugar, and then the fruit will eventually come. So, and this system, of course, it's applicable to the entire railwork. And the advantage of this system is, of course, that you need a lot less trains. It's a lot more efficient, cheaper, and as you can see, cities are growing. Because they get exactly what they need. For example, here is another cluster like this. But they don't need most goods they can deliver. And the same then down here. You don't need always good. You can see you can have like three or four goods. You can have like these three goods. Or maybe you just have one. For example, here you have Durham and Jolla to produce beer. And you have this Anderson farm that puts the grain. You don't need a warehouse system here. You can simply make a station from here, then delivers to Charlotte and Durham, and that's it. And then whenever you have another system, warehouse down here or up here or whatever, we deliver to Durham and Charlotte, they can then pick up the beer and deliver it everywhere else. So, and actually, I'm stupid. You don't even need, you probably don't even need this train here. Only if the utilization is over 100% or close to 100%, you need a train. Because that would mean that it cannot, 100% means it's bottlenecked. Otherwise, it doesn't need. You don't make any money from delivering grain from here to here. You only get the money from the beer delivered to elsewhere. Only goods delivered to a city bring you money. Goods delivered from one station, a rural station, to another station or a warehouse, does not make you money. That being said, this would be actually sent to a city. I don't know if this, I don't think it would make any money. It makes many, maybe it makes a little bit money, but I don't think it's worth it. But again, once it hit 100%, then maybe. But that's all I have for now. If you have any comments, then please leave a comment. Leave a like if you learned something. Share with your friends who are clueless or not. Let's pretend I didn't say that. And yeah, subscribe if you want to see more. Hit the notification bell so you're ready for the next. As you can see, Philadelphia is growing as well. It really takes not much. One or two trains per city, it's all it needs. So yeah, that's it for today. Thanks for watching. Bye.